This idea was developed by Andrew Yao in the 1980s, and it gives a way to perform any function as a secure computation. And the idea is that any discrete fixed-size function can be turned into logic gates, and then if we can find a way to implement logic gates securely, we can implement a whole function this way. So we can think of a logic gate as a truth table. Let's take, for example, the function AND. AND takes two inputs and produces one output. And we can describe that AND with a table of values. We'll use 0 to represent false and 1 to represent true. So this is a regular AND gate. And if we evaluate the AND gate, well, we need to know the actual values of A and B. Suppose the value of A is 1 and the value of B is 0. Then we would take this line from the truth table and know that the output has the value 0. And our goal is to encrypt the circuit in such a way that we can still evaluate it without actually knowing what the inputs are and without learning what the output is, but still produce an output that we can use as the input to the next circuit. If we can evaluate each gate this way, keeping the inputs and outputs encrypted, we can evaluate the whole circuit. And at the end, we can map the final result to a meaningful value. So our first step to creating an encrypted circuit is to replace the inputs with encrypted values. That means we need some way to represent a 0 on this wire and some way to represent a 1, same for this wire. So we're going to replace these zeros and ones in the table with encrypted values. We'll just look at those as random nonces. So we're going to pick some random value to represent 0 on this wire. Let's call that A0. We'll pick some random value to represent 1. We'll call that A1. And we'll do the same thing for the other wire. And we'll do the same thing for the output. So here's our new truth table. Well, if we keep things in the same order, we haven't hidden anything. So let's randomly permute it. And now suppose we get a table like this. That means that A0 is either 0010 or 1010. So now the question is, can you determine what is the value of B0? If you could, well, that would mean you know the semantic value of B. So you can tell if it's equal to B0 or not. And that would mean you're evaluating the circuit and you're learning the values in the circuit, so you don't have the secure computation you wanted to. Can you determine the value of B0 knowing this garbled table?